Hello everyone, myself Rahul Kumar, Assistant Professor of Department of Mechanical Engineering, Suresh Gyanvir University, Jaipur. This is the lecture series of hydraulic mechanics subject. This is lecture number 3 and today I will discuss about the surface tension and capillarity effect on fluid. And the subject code is here, ME317, unit number 1st and lecture number is 3. So, move to the next slide. For the today topic, I will discuss in this lecture. These are surface tension effect on bubble and liquid droplets, capillarity, expression for capillary rise, expression for capillary fall, and some numerical problem related to surface tension and capillary effect, right? And then objective of the fluid properties. For the objective is in surface tension topic, the student able to understand the phenomena of surface tension of a liquid, the phenomena of surface tension of a liquid and forces acting between the surface, forces acting between the surface, and study about the expression of capillary rise and fall also, and define the nature of fluid, and we can predict the tendency and behavior of the fluid molecules, right? But in gaseous molecules, surface tension is not exist here, right? And what is the main problem is here? What is the surface tension? Generally, it is called, this is a tendency of liquid of surface at rest to shrink into the minimum surface area possible, means it can always cover the minimum area. And surface tension is what allows heavier than water, that is denser than water object such as razor blades, insects, and some like as a spider to float and slide on the water surface without becoming even partially submerged, right? So these are the some phenomena just you seen in the general practice. Some insects are running on the water top. This is the phenomena of surface tension. At liquid and air interfaces, and liquid and air interfaces, surface tension results from the greater attraction of liquid molecule to each other than to molecule in the air, right? So due to this surface tension creates, and surface tension form a free surface of liquid, right? This is the tendency of surface tension. And in this slide, it is given one definition of this surface tension. And surface tension is defined as the tensile force. Surface tension is defined as the tensile force acting on the surface. As a tensile force acting on the surface of liquid in contact with a gas, or the surface behaves like as a membrane under tension, means this surface acts like a membrane, tensile membrane, which is situated on the surface of the liquid, right? And the magnitude of the force per unit length of free surface, per unit length of the free surface, will have the same value as the surface energy per unit area, surface energy per unit area, right? And here I will take one example. These are the three liquid molecules, and these are A, B, and C. For the A molecule is fully submerged in the water. But for the B molecule is partially submerged. And for the case of C molecules, half side submerged in water. So what will happen, right? In these type of molecules, the surface tension phenomena is explained by taking this type of example, right? In this case, the A molecule is attracted in all direction. In this case, A molecules feels equal force in all directions. But in the case of B and C, which is situated near the surface and is act upon upward and downward force. Here, the surface forces are not balanced. For the B case and C case, here the surface forces are not balanced. But in the case of A, the resultant force acting on the all direction, this is equal to zero. So this is a richer molecule. But in the case of B and C, these are the very, B is some poor molecules, but C is a very poor molecules. So the tendency of the these two molecules will become richer molecules. But A is always richer molecules. So this always gives a one force to the upward force, this B and C molecules. And here the free surface of liquid is like as a free surface of liquid feels like as a membrane. So this is the air and here is liquid. So the here is always act as a one unbalanced force on these two molecules. Thus the resultant force on molecules B is acting in the downward direction, and the molecule C is situated on the free surface of liquid does experience a resultant force also in the downward direction, and all the molecules on the free surface experience a downward force. Thus the free surface of liquid acts like a very thin film under the tension of the surface. And it acts like elastic membrane. Upper surface of the liquid acts like as a elastic membrane, and this effect of the liquid form a free surface on the form a free surface on the surface of liquid. This is called surface tension. This is called the surface tension. Here, the surface tension denoted by a Greek letter sigma. Here, the surface tension denoted by a Greek letter sigma in MKS unit. In MKS unit, it is expressed as kilogram kgf per meter, while in SI units as Newton per meter, while as the SI units Newton per meter, right? So this is the simple way to understand what is the surface tension and what is the surface tension effect on the liquid, right? And then move to the next slide. This is the surface tension on liquid. These are the three cases. First is water droplet, pressure force, and the what type of surface tension act on this droplet, right? For this case, consider a small spherical droplet. Consider a small spherical droplet of a liquid of radius r. Of radius r on the entire, suppose this is the radius r of the liquid spherical droplet, and the tensile force due to the surface tension will be acting. Let sigma is the surface tension of the liquid and p is the pressure intensity inside the droplet. Some pressure acts on the outside of the due to atmosphere from the outside, and some is inside, right? In excess of outside pressure intensity at the outside, and d is the diameter of the droplet. Let the droplet is cut into two halves. The forces acting on the half, say left half, will be given in the next slide also, right? So this is the phenomena of liquid droplet, right? Okay, sorry for some disturbance, and then move to the next slide also. And this is the surface tension and capillarity effect. This is the surface tension and capillarity effect. In the surface tension, it defined as the tensile force acting on the surface of a liquid in contact with a gas, are on the surface between the two immiscible liquids. Surface on the two immiscible liquids, just like the two different types of liquids. This free surface of liquid form here, the two different types of, or two different densities of liquid are, or we can say the fluids are present, right? Such that the contact surface between, like a membrane under tension, then the surface tension is created due to the unbalanced cohesive forces. Then surface tension is created due to the unbalanced cohesive forces acting on the liquid molecules at the fluid surface. These molecules in the interior of the fluid mass and surrounded by molecules that are attracted to each other equally. However, the molecules along the surface are subjected to a net force towards the interior. The apparent physical consequence of this unbalanced force along the surface is to create a hypothetical skin. This hypothetical skin has to run on the water to insect. Means we can say that insects run on the water surface due to this hypothetical skin or membrane, right? So this is the case of surface tension, right? This is the case of surface tension effect. Then this is one more example. One is molecules on the surface, and here is a molecule inside the liquid. This experience a equilibrium condition, but this feels like as a unequilibrium position. So any unequilibrium molecules, its tendency to reach the equilibrium position. So it's always acts a downward force. It always acts a downward force in the downward direction. But this equilibrium molecules always produces a one upward force. So here downward and upward force here creates a one type of tension, right, on the upper surface of the liquid. So a tensile force may be considered to be acting in the plane of the surface along any line in the surface. The intensity of molecular attraction, per unit length along any line, in the surface is called the surface tension, right? But the unit of surface tension is here. This is a Newton per meter, right? This is a SI unit. Move to the next slide. Surface tension on liquid droplet and bubble. This is the half of droplet and this is the half of bubble. In the case of bubble, it experiences only one surface. That is surface tension. But in the case of bubble, it experiences two-way surface tension effect. Consider a small spherical droplet of a liquid. Droplet of a liquid of radius r on the entire surface of the droplet. The tensile force due to surface tension will be acting. Suppose sigma be the surface tension of the liquid and delta P, this is the pressure intensity inside the droplet. And the R is the radius of the droplet. Let the droplet is cut into two halves. The forces acting on the one half, say left side, will be P pi r square into P bubble, and this is the surface tension force and this is the pressure force. So here just you see in these figures, the surface tension act like as a outward force, but pressure force always act in the downward direction, right? So the pressure force is pi r square delta P droplet, and surface tension force, just like as in the case of droplet, here only single skin is present. So here is 2 pi r into sigma s. But in the case of bubble, here the two types of skin are present here. One is outer and another one is inner. So two types of surface tension is present in the case of bubble. So the 2 into 2 pi r into sigma s, this is the condition of the surface tension present in the Baba Lal, sir, right? And this is the tensile force due to the surface tension acting. This is the tensile force due to the surface tension acting around the circumference of the cut portion as shown, and this is equal to sigma into circumference equal to sigma into 2 pi r equal to sigma into 2 pi r. This will give the 2 pi r into sigma, right? Like this. This is this force. And for the pressure force on the area, pi by 4 into d square and delta b into x into pi r square, as shown in this diagram. Right? And surface tension and capillarity. These two forces will be equal and opposite under equilibrium condition. Means these surface tension force and pressure force. These are two forces acting as a opposite forces. So for the equilibrium forces, these two forces are equal in both case. So for the case of droplet. For the case of droplet, here the 2 pi r sigma s equal to pi r square into delta p. It will give say delta p for droplet. This is equal to pi minus p0 equal to 2 sigma s divided by r. This is the pressure inside the droplet, just like it is to 2 sigma s divided by r. But in the case of bubble, here the surface tension act on the both sides. Both side means outer and inner surface. Outer and inner surface of this. This is the outer, and here is this is the inner surface of the bubble. So the formula is here: delta p for bubble equal to 4 sigma s r. This is a very important question for the gate point of view and any other competition exam, because lot of question ask by this topic, right? A hollow bubble like a soap bubble in air surface with air, one inside and other outside. The two surfaces are subjected surface tension. The two surfaces are subjected to surface tension, right? This is a numerical problem. Just you read this question. Find the surface tension in a soap bubble of 40 mm diameter. So what the diameter of the bubble is here? 40 mm. When the inside pressure is 2.5 newton per meter square above the atmospheric pressure, then the diameter of bubble d equal to 40 mm equal to 40 into 10 to power minus 3, 40 into 10 to power minus 3 meter, and pressure is excess of outside, just like the p equal to 2.5 newton per meter square. This is the given data from the question. Then for the soap bubble, using here like this, right? Here is r. R is the d by 2, d equal to 2 1, then r equal to d by 2. So the formula is here, h sigma divided by t. Put the value of pressure in this 2.5 in this formula, and then you will get a value of sigma. Means this is the value of surface tension of water, right? So this is a very simple question. then move to the question number 2. Then move to the question number 2. First you collect the data from the question. First you collect the data from the question. In this question, the pressure outside the droplet of water of diameter 0.04 mm. The pressure outside the droplet of the water of and for this example number 2, this question related to the surface tension of droplet, and this is the bubble case. But in this question, this is a droplet case. The pressure outside the droplet of a water of diameter 0.04 mm, water of diameter 0.04 mm is 10.32 newton per centimeter square. This is the atmospheric pressure. And calculate the pressure within the droplet. If surface tension is given as 0.0725 newton per meter of water, then the diameter of droplet here D equal to 0.04 mm. This is equal to 0.04 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. And pressure outside the droplet is declared at 10.32 newton per centimeter square equal to 10.32 into 10 to the power 4 newton per meter square. And for the surface tension here is sigma equal to 0.0725 newton per meter. And the pressure inside the droplet in excess of outside pressure is given by, this is equal to P equal to 4 sigma divided by T. Then 4 into 0.0725 divided by 0.04 10 to power minus 3, this is equal to 7250 newton per meter square. If I am converting this meter into centimeter, then I will divide this digit into the 10 to power 4 centimeter square. Then the solution is 0.75 newton per centimeter square, right? For this case, pressure inside the droplet is equal to P plus pressure outside the droplet. Pressure outside the droplet. So for this case, P equal to 0.725 plus 10.32 equal to 11.045 newton per centimeter square, right? So this is the value of surface tension outside the droplet. Surface tension portion for the pressure outside the droplet is here, right? Then move to the next section. And this is the MCQ sections. This is the first question for the MCQ problem. Can you guess? What is the unit of surface tension in CGS system? what the unit of surface tension in CGS system. Newton per meter, kg per centimeter, dynes per centimeter, and dynes per meter. But here CGS system is here CGS. So for this case, dynes per centimeter is the correct answer. Dynes per centimeter is the correct answer for this question. The unit of surface tension in CGS system is dynes per centimeter. But in the case of SI system, the unit is Newton per meter. And the surface tension is an elastic tendency. Surface tension is the elastic tendency of a fluid surface, which makes it acquire the least surface area possible. So the right answer is for this question is here, dynes per centimeter. Then move to the next question. What the next question is here? The operators used for determination of surface tension of a liquid. The operators is used for the determination of surface tension of a liquid. First question, option is here, odiometer, stalagmometer, consolidometer, and none of the information. So just you think about the right answer. What the correct answer for this question is here? The correct answer for this question is here, this stalagmometer. Stalagmometer used to determine the surface tension of a liquid, and it is equivalent to force per unit length, and it works just like as a equivalent force to per unit length. And this is the correct answer for this MCQ problem number 2. And then move to the third problem. This problem related to this second question, right? In this problem, a stalagmometer is cleaned to remove grease with the help of which acid remove the grease from the stalagmometer, right? Then here are the four acids, are four liquids are present here. One is chromic acid, sulfuric acid, distilled water, and tartaric acid. What is the correct answer for this? Did you think about this? And the correct answer is chromic acid. A stalagmometer is cleaned to remove the gases with the help of chromic acid, right? It is used for determination to find the surface tension of liquid, right? This is the correct answer. Chromic acid used to remove the grease from the stalagmometer, right? The surface tension of water at 25 degrees Celsius. What is the surface tension value of water? Right? This is a very simple question. The surface tension of water at 25 degrees Celsius is what the value of this? 25 degrees Celsius is 72.14 dynes per centimeter. So this is the correct answer. This is the correct answer for this question, right? This is the correct answer for this question. Then move to the next question. On increasing the temperature, the kinetic energy of liquid molecule. On increasing the temperature, the kinetic energy of liquid molecules. Which will be increases, decreases, remains constant? None of them. Means inside the liquid, I will give one point. Inside the liquid molecules always randomly oriented, but it makes a free surface due to cohesive forces. If I am increasing the in kinetic energy with the help of temperature, right? So what will be here? This kinetic energy is increases due to its temperature, due to the random motion of the molecules. And if I am increasing the temperature of the liquid, in this case, the liquid molecules cohesive force is less. At this condition, cohesive forces act on these two molecules, and molecules experience less cohesive forces. And the motion of the, if cohesive force is less, then the motion of the molecules is more. If velocity of the molecules is increased, the kinetic energy, what is the kinetic energy? Half mv square, mass is same, but velocity is increases, so the kinetic energy of the liquid molecules is increases. So the correct answer for this question is 5A, increases. Kinetic energy of the liquid molecule is increases, right? And then move to the next question, 6. In the case of water and glass, we get a concave meniscus because of adhesive forces between water and glass are, this is the blank, then the cohesive forces between the water and molecules, weaker, stronger, same, and none of the mentioned. This is a very good question for the competition point of view. Suppose I will give some hint. In the case of water and glass, we get a concave meniscus because the adhesive forces between the water and glass are stronger than the cohesive forces between water and molecule. The correct answer for this question is here stronger. Well, and move to the question number 7. Shapes of drops of liquid are spherical because of its width property, viscosity, conductivity, absorption, surface tension. Right? The answer is, this is a very good question. Shapes of the liquid means which property tends to minimize the surface area. This is the property of surface tension. So this is a correct answer. Surface tension is the correct answer for this question. right? Here, shapes of the drum, drops of liquid are spherical because the surface tension as it reduces the surface area to a minimum. So this is the right answer for this question. Then move to the 8th question. Select the incorrect statement from the following option. Select the incorrect statement. In the case of mercury and glass, we observe a convex minuscule. This is the right sentence. The second sentence, surface tension is responsible for rise and fall of the capillary tube. Surface tension is responsible for the rise and fall of the capillary tube. This is right. Surface tension is responsible for this both cases. Next is, if two drops encounter each other, they tend to ripple each other. Means two liquid droplets, just like a two liquid droplets, I'm dropping a two liquid droplet and then meet with two together. Suppose this is a one and liquid droplet, and this is a second another liquid droplet. If this meets with each other, then it creates a ripple force or attractive force. So two liquid droplets always meet by a attractive force. Right? It combines with each other and creates one big liquid droplet. So this is the right answer for this question. This is the wrong statement. Right? This is the wrong statement. And then move to the next problem. This is the question number 9. On increasing the temperature, the surface tension of liquid, on increasing the temperature, the surface tension of liquid. What the tendency of this? Surface tension of liquid, this is decreases, increases, remain constant, and none of the above. This is decreases. Surface tension of liquid is decreases in this case. Why? If I am increasing this temperature, the surface tension of the liquid is decreases. It is inversely proportional of the temperature, right? Then move to the question number 10. This is the last question. Which of the following is an application of surface tension? Which of the following is an application of surface tension? Use the soap bubble and detergent as cleansing agent. This is the application of surface tension. Molecular structure can be elucidated by surface tension measurements through pressure value. This is the right application of surface tension. And surface tanks are incorporated in preparation like toothpaste. This is also application of surface tension. Then all of the mentioned. So these three are the application of the surface tension. So this is correct answer for this question is here. D is the correct answer. Right? So this is the MCQ section is over. Then come references for this chapter is here. First is Indian Fluid Mechanics by K.L. Kumar. Fluid Mechanics and Machine. FM White, Fluid Mechanics and Machine, A.K. Jain, and Fluid Mechanics, B.L. Steeper, and Fluid Mechanics with Applications, H.C. Gupta, V. Gupta, for New Age Application. This is the books. I will recommend this book. This is a very good book for the more introduction about the surface tension and other related topic related to hydraulic machine, right? So thank you for this class, and thank you all of you.